So today we'll be discussing chapter number one, a computer system overview. In this, we'll be talking about the basic introduction, then the components of the basic computer organization, computer components and basic computer organization. Then we'll be talking about the mobile system organization and the types of softwares. Okay. So first of all, we'll be talking about the term hardware and the software. As we know that hardware is basically the tangible object which can be touched and feel, right? For example, you've got keyboard, CPU, monitor, and printer. Software, which are intangible, you can only feel them, that you know they are, something is working. That is basically software, right? Think of that, you are pressing a button of your device, and the device is working. So something is working internally, right? You're feeling that, you know, something is working. Something is there to take your inputs and work accordingly on that. So this, these are certain examples of softwares. Then the components of basic computer system organization is input unit, output unit, right? And input unit and output unit. Then we've got the CPU, central processing unit as well, primary memory and secondary store unit. Okay, so these are certain components we've already discussed, and this can be understood using this basic computer system organization. This has got, you know, the input unit is there. Then CPU comes into the picture along with it, basically uses the memory. Okay, may use the storage unit to store that information which is being processed, and then finally the output has been produced. Input unit. An input unit takes the input and converts it into binary form so that it can be understood by the computer. For example, we've got keyboard, we've got mouse, we've got joystick, we've got touch screens, we've got, you know, so many other, you know, optical character reader also. You know, these are certain devices which can be used as an input unit, which are the part of input unit rather. Then output units, they, you know, converts output in binary form to a human readable form. For example, your printer, your screen, output screen, monitor, you know, and speakers also, you know, because the sound which you listen is basically an output form. And the CPU, this is the main, you know, unit, which can be considered as a brain of the computer. And it has got ALU, CU, and registers. ALU, it performs all the arithmetic logical operations, and control unit, it controls entire, you know, inputs and pass it on to the different, you know, components to work upon it. And register is basically nothing but a memory, which is associated to the processor, okay? So then we'll be talking about the main memory. Main memory is basically the primary memory, which is actually a you know, a RAM, and any input which you give to the computer, it straight away goes to the RAM to process, okay, and it is also known as the volatile memory, because as soon as you just turn off the system or due to any reason if your system gets crashed, then in that case the information which you have stored here will be vanished off and cannot be recovered. These are certain units of your computer memory measurement. Then parts of main memory. We've got a DRAM and SRAM, dynamic RAM and the static RAM. Then we've got read-only memory. It has got various parts, first of all, we need to understand the ROM, what exactly read-only memory is. It's a memory unit that performs a read operations only. It does not have a write capability. This implies that the binary information stored in ROM is made permanent during the hardware production of unit and cannot be altered by writing different words into it, hence non-volatile. These are certain various types of ROM. One is PROM, EPROM, EEPROM, flash EEPROM, and mask ROM. Then cache memory, It's a high-speed memory available inside CPU in order to speed up access to data and instructions stored in the RAM memory. The storage unit, where we store information for the later purpose, it has got hard disk, CD-ROMs, DVD, and pen drive. The system bus, they are basically the channels to, which carries information from one component to another component within the system. Then we've got mobile processors. Obviously, this is something like the CPU, which is the brain of the smartphone, right? And it controls all the operations, the communications, the applications, and everything. It controls everything within the mobile. And then we'll be talking about the types of softwares. We have mainly two types of softwares are there: system and application. System, which are the basic need of the computer to run or any system to run. For example, you have got the operating system and the language processors. These are the system softwares. And application softwares, they are the softwares which are made for the specific task. For example, word processing for the documentation, Excel for the calculations or accounting, and PPT for the presentation and all, right? So these are some examples of the application and system softwares. Then in language processors, we have got assembler, interpreter, and compiler, right? These are the language processors which are used to convert one language into the machine language so that the machine can understand what exactly has been written or what is exactly is basically been input from the user and what system has to work on that, right? Then I've already discussed about the application softwares, and this is the working hierarchy in a computer, right? We have certain business softwares, which are specifically, designed for business purposes. For example, you've got inventory management system, and they are the generalized softwares as well as the customized softwares as well. Generalized one like Tally is a generalized one. Okay, and if we ask to any vendor to design an application for our school accounting purpose, so that will be the customized software because that will be designed specifically for our school's need. Then software library is a predefined and available to use, a suite to data and programming code in the form of pre-written code, functions, scripts, classes, etc. that can be used in the development of a new software program and applications. Like Python has got various functions within the library, within the specified libraries. We have got like NumPy, SciPy, Panda library, which are going to be used to design the applications in Python. Thank you very much. And that is all for the day.